I'm mad as hell, and I'm not going to let up. And people are like, well, why don't you do something? Well, I'm as frustrated as anyone else because I've been trying to do something for 5 years, but I'm not getting a whole lot of support and not getting a lot of folks that are actually focused on the real problem.
That is Governor Larry Hogan on the C4 show today. C4, who you hear 9 to 1 every day on WBAL, joins me now. Presumably you were going to talk about the Kirwan Commission hearing, and the governor said something at the outset that, and several witnesses yesterday said it was life or death, the Kirwan Commission, when in fact, in the governor's view, Kirwan is not. There's a more serious problem.
The more serious problem is what Governor Hogan faced when he went to Lexington Market today. He was here for a really tremendous project to redo the entire Lexington Market, which used to be my old legislative district. And the governor said everybody who approached him, number one issue was crime, trying to deal with the fact that since February the 7th through yesterday, we have had 13 homicides and well over 30 shootings. And yet we keep talking about other issues.
The governor is getting a lot of resistance on his crime package,
yeah.
Which includes the tougher sentences for repeat violent offenders, yep. The judicial transparency measure,
and witness intimidation.
Gets a lot of resistance, particularly from the judiciary. Witness intimidation. Marilyn Mosby opposes the extra money for the attorney general's office, saying that money should go to her.
Well, the problem, Robert, is if the city and its officials were being effective, then I could understand their opposition to different ideas, whether it's Governor Hogan or whether it's other state legislators. We have State Senator J.B. Jennings, who's talking about making sure that school police officers have the ability to carry weapons in school. If we didn't have 27
although that particular bill has gone nowhere year after year.
I understand that. But if we didn't have 27 loaded guns taken off students in the last 2 or 3 years, then I could understand the resistance from city legislators if we were doing things that were effective. But most people look at what is being offered from outside to say, whether it's Governor Hogan, whether it's Senator James, they go, why are you being oppositional to this when what we're doing isn't working?
Switching to Kirwan very quickly, you watched a lot of the hearing yesterday.
Six and a half hours,
and the runtime was expected to be six
yeah.
and a half hours. Where do we go from here on this?
Where we go is that was part one, by the way, of the hearing.
Yeah.
The next part is supposed to be dealing more with the funding apparatus, where yesterday was really all about ideas and things. This is going to pass, Robert. They have overwhelming support for this. The question is going to be, even though the first 3 years are paid for, according to Adrian Jones, the Speaker of the House, what happens in the out years? We have the same language for Thornton. It's paid for next year. It's paid for the year after. But we saw a structural deficit that was put in place that lasted a decade. That's what people's concerns are.
We close with some good news. Officer Swinney, the Baltimore County officer who was shot and wounded last week in Northeast Baltimore, released from
excellent,
shock trauma
Robert,
today.
Excellent.
So both officers are now home. C4 show back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.